Welcome to the video tutorial on assisting the filling up of the foreign direct investment survey for year 2019 conducted by the Directorate of Company Administration, DICA, for Myanmar. My name is Amila and I work as a short-term expert for the International Monetary Fund. IMF have collaborated with DICA since 2017 to compile FDI statistics. We are doing this series of short videos particularly focusing on new companies that have been added to the survey this year. This demonstration comprises of three short videos on how to fill the general FDI survey form. If you are a company in the oil and gas sector, this is not the survey form to be filled, and I advise you to contact DICA for any necessary instructions. This video will look at the initial prerequisites to be filled in the survey form. The next video will look at the equity side of the survey form, and the third video, the final one, will look at the debt side of the survey form. Let me show you the FDI survey form in the Excel format first. This is the FDI survey form for DICA for year 2019 and 20. This Excel sheet is available in the DICA website, where you also found the link to these videos. We appreciate you responding in the Excel format and replying to DICA by email before the stipulated deadline. With that introduction, let me give you a quick example on how to fill the FDI survey form of general companies. If you need any further instruction, please feel free to call DICA or contact them by email. We appreciate your kind cooperation and hope that you will respond to the survey on time in order to make the FDI compilation process in Myanmar a success. With that introduction, let me give a small tutorial on how to fill the survey form. In this survey form, there are a number of sheets. The first one is the instructions. You can read at your leisure. We have included all the instructions to be filled, to be followed when filling the survey form. And then there is the identification where the basic details of the company are asked. And then there are some characteristics of the company is asked, and these three will be looked at in this video quickly. And then there is the main worksheets. Two main worksheets are there. One is on the equity side. This is the equity worksheet, and the other one is the debt side, the debt worksheet. So let's look at the first part, the identification part. In the first part is pretty straightforward. This is your company's name. If you are an FDI company, if you are an FDI company, if they are a direct investor that has invested in your company, that is a non-resident who owns voting shares of your company of more than 10% of your company, he is called a direct investor. And if there is a direct investor in your company, you are included in this FDI survey form. But since you are receiving this, that means already there are direct investors in your company. So here you have the company name, the address, the township and the state, the basic data. So the company name could be company A. Let's say company ABC. So address could be number 30 Yangon or a similar address. So there will be a township and then there will be a state and region also. So you can select from this list, right? And then there is the company registration number, which is the DICA registration number, and the date of the registration, which you also know. And also there are some companies that also have the MIC permit, or there are companies that belong to the special economic zones, like the special economic zone in Tilawa, or there are other registrations like the registration with MOGE or Ministry of Electricity and Energy. So this company could be belonging to the Tilawa special economic zone. If you are belonging to Tilawa special economic zone, you can put your details here. So this will be the contact name of the person that that is responding to you. So these are the very basic details. Then we go on to the characteristics. So the first question that is asked is, did any non-resident investor, resident owner, shareholder own more than 10% of the equity capital of your enterprise? That means a foreign investor has to own more than 10% of the company to be a direct investment enterprise. and this should be yes. If this is no, that means you don't have to fill the survey. That means you are almost 90% locally owned. So if it there is more than 10% foreign ownership by a single shareholder, that shareholder is considered as a direct investor and should be included in this survey. So in most cases, this would be yes. And then there are some basic questions that are asked, like the number of employees. Number of employees at the beginning of the year, it could be 100 or so. So then there are number of non-resident employees, which could be 10 or 5, for example. And the number of resident employees, therefore, would be 95. This is just an example to show how to fill the form. So the type of the legal organization here is, there could be 100% ownership by a foreigner. So there could be a joint venture or a BOT contract, that is the build, operate and transfer, or a profit sharing contract, production sharing contract, a branch, or a petroleum recovery contract. In most cases, for general FDI companies, it is either 100% ownership or a joint venture. Let's look at a 50-50 ownership of the company, that is a joint venture. And then let's say this company ABC is making apparel, making t-shirts and exporting t-shirts. So this would be production of menswear for exports. So for each of the activities, there is a specific IASC revision. So this revision can be found in the activity sheets here. In the activity sheet, if you are a apparel company, the number would be number 14, manufacturer of wearing apparel. So if you are producing a food or a food item, it will be number 10, manufacturing of food products. If you are manufacturing a beverage, it will be number 11. So likewise, there are more than close to 100 different types of activities in the services sector, activities in administration, real estate activities, hotels, all these are covered. So you can put what is the correct activity here under the characteristics. For in this case, it should be number 14 because it's a production of menswear. So it would be wearing apparel, manufacturing of wearing apparel. And then we ask some basic questions about the company. This is to have an overall idea about the company. So what you can do is to these financial figures, you can fill in any currency. And most probably it is filled in Myanmar chats or in USD millions, right? So mostly the accounting is done in Myanmar chats. And in some cases it's done in USD millions. It doesn't matter, you do not have to convert to any currency. You can use the currency that your accounts are made of. So if it is USD million, you can use USD million. So you could have about 100 million profit. So make sure if this is million, you are putting here in millions and not in USD, because it will make a big difference. And net profit before tax, let's say it could be 15 million. And then out of the profit, there could be a dividend, let's say 5 million. And after the dividends, there are some retained earnings or losses. In this case, it is a retained earning, and we can consider this as 10 million. So likewise, this financial data for that year is available in your balance sheet. Use the balance sheet to look at the basic financial details of the company. So if you're using Myanmar chats, please indicate here that you are using Myanmar chats, because it is very important that this currency and this number matches. So in the next videos, we will look at the equity part, which is the major part, and the debt instrument part in the next video for the general FDI companies. Thank you very much.